everybody. I'm Aimee DeRoehn. Thanks for joining Road Home Empower, a 30-minute show, this time, Stratton Mountain, Wanderlust, summer 2014. If you've never been to a Wanderlust, I recommend that you run, don't walk, to your nearest Wanderlust weekend or week. Really want to emphasize just flat out breathe in and breathe out. When you hear that instruction, do that. My voice is always just leading you back to you remembering and to remind yourself this is time to inhale. And whenever you feel like I can't get air, know that that's when you need to get the air cleared out first. We can't take in something new until we have cleared out. And the exhale represents that. And the inhale represents fresh air. So, through this practice, you are going to refresh yourself, restore yourself, empower yourself, and hopefully, if I do the job right, you're going to leave the mat and you're going to feel just more inspired to be a little better than you were the day before. Let's go ahead and let's come right into downward facing dog. Hands shoulder width apart, feet separated out, hip width, pressing your hips way back, drop that head. Let your eyes land between your feet. A lot of people don't know this, but the eyes are part of the nervous system. So if you're focusing on your inhale and your exhale, and your eyes are between your feet, staring right at this one space, you can really start to focus on the breath, and that'll start to quiet your mind, and that'll settle your nervous system. Take a deep breath in. Open mouth, free sigh. When you don't hear yourself, that's how you know you're out of your own way. Bring your feet together. Use your inhale to lengthen your leg right on up. If you're at home, lengthen it up to the ceiling. If you're outside, keep your leg up to the sky, the ceiling of the sky. Bend your upper knee, flex the foot, and as you exhale, roll open. A little bit at a time is how we're going to do this. Floor. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, bend the upper knee, flex that foot, and roll it open. So ideally, you want your knee and hip to line up, and you want to use your exhale to peel that left hip a little bit back. All this practice is about, bring your foot to the ground. All this practice is about is simply bringing yourself into a little more opening. Walk your feet up to the mat, to the front edge. Halfway up, lengthen on the in-breath. On your out-breath, fold forward. Drop your head. You want to get out of your head the rest of the day, your evening? Drop your friggin' skull. Just drop it. Let it drop like a weight. I promise you'll think clearer the rest of the evening. Reach all the way up, palms tucked. Exhale, bring your hands right to your good heart. Take a deep breath in, reach high. Empty the breath. Knees need to deeply bend. Breathe out to fold. Halfway up, inhale. Step back into a high push-up. Your shoulders are right over your wrists. And I recommend being on the balls of the feet and pressing your heels straight back. If this is too much, take it down. Sometimes less is more. You bring your knees down on the ground, tops of the feet down, and then you rock the chest forward as you breathe in, and as you exhale, elbows hug to your sides, chest lowers. Now take a breath in, up dog. See, we take a breath in because the lungs and shoulders are a little more open, and empty all that air out. Downward dog. It's the breath in and the breath out. It's gonna help you feel more connected to your down dog, essentially to your body, ultimately to yourself. But not your usual self, not your same old, not your ego. Even better version of yourself than that. Take a deep breath in, exhale out some of your personality. might have been shaped by simply people who told you stuff about yourself that wasn't true. A lot of our belief systems are actually BS. Walk your feet, fall home. Halfway up, breathe in. If you need to take it your hands to your shins, you can come halfway up that way. The key is to lift your chest high and take a breath. And then empty that breath all out. Fold. And then ground down through the feet as you rise up. If you're reaching up to the sky, you still want to feel grounded. You want to feel grounded. You want to feel like you're on your feet while you're reaching for the heavens, okay? Otherwise, the castle up in the heavens is going to all crumble because you're going to lose it. Just look at Lindsay Lohan, for God's sakes. Reach up. Empty the breath. Bow forward. Halfway up. Breathe in. Step back. High push up. Exhale. Low. Inhale. Upward dog. The tops of the feet are pressing down. If you're strong enough, pull your thighs up. Shoulders back. Take a breath in. Clear it all. Breathe in. Dump it. Inhale. Empty out. When you really clear your out breath, it's crazy, but you'll become your own clearing of some of your thoughts. Maybe the mood might feel kind of dense that day because your feelings are heavy-hearted or you're stuck on something. And the practice of yoga is going to help you get unstuck. I'm only sharing this with you so much because that's what yoga did for me, personally. Halfway up, lengthen. Forward fold. Empty all your air. You'll immediately come into a deeper fold when you deeply exhale to the very bottom of your lungs. And you'll see something's complete. And then you're rising up, 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 up. And you'll bring your hands right to your heart center. And now we've done all that. We've woken up the body a little bit. We've gotten into our feet and our legs. Let's take it in a little bit further. So we're gonna get the bugs out of my face first. And then we're gonna bring your feet together. And you're gonna bend your knees and kind of drop your hips down. Like you're sitting in your old kindergarten chair. And then I want you to think, geez, how far have I come from that day? Sit down a little lower and breathe as though your life depended on it. Because if you're not breathing, you're in survival in this pose. As you keep sinking down, stretch your arms, stretch your fingers, stretch your heart higher. Exhale, bow. Halfway. High push up. Lower. Upward facing. Your heart's opening up. No matter who hurt you and kind of wanted to test you to see if you'd close it, you don't want to do that. Not only, yes, you'll keep yourself safe, but the downside is you don't get to feel the love that's really out there for you. For the people that didn't hurt you. The people that deserve it, deserve your love. Exhale, down dog. Take your right foot, step it forward. Ground your back foot down. Use your inhale to come up. You want to bend your front knee, and you're going to press it open toward the baby toe side of the foot. You're going to squeeze your back leg like crazy. Like it's just concrete, okay? And then you're gonna use your inhale to take your arms up. You're gonna sink in a little bit deeper. You're gonna make sure that your lower back, your tailbone, lengthens toward the back heel. You'll feel that pull on the hip flexor. I feel it too. I feel you. Right hip back. Reach. Hands to the ground. High push up. Exhale, lower. Inhale, up. empty, down dog.
Left foot, step it forward. Back foot, ground it down. Inhale up to stand. So you keep that back leg straight by pressing through the outer edge of the back foot. You then can squeeze open that front knee toward the baby toe side of the foot. That's going to start opening up this hip. And I want you to do that. I don't want you to leave this class and shut the TV off or the computer off and say, I didn't get much out of that. If you're not breathing, you're not going to get much. You want to get something out of this. And that something is you want yoga to pull something bigger inside you out with us. So sometimes we got to go to those places we don't want to. Like a little kid, I don't want to. Breathe into that space. Breathe out.
High plank. Lower.
Heart open. Up dog.
Exhale, clear it. Deep breath in. Out with that.
Feet together, belly tight. When you get the air out, you want to make sure that you squeeze your belly in. Bend the knees, hop, feet to hands.
Halfway up,
fold.
Bend your knees, sit those hips lower, reach up. Pull the hands to the heart, fold.
Halfway up, step back, high push up. Exhale with a smile on your face. Being enthused about creating more strength. Upward dog. Pull back, down dog. Take your right foot, step it forward. Back foot down.
Warrior one, come up. Open yourself into warrior two. Take your left arm, wrap it around your waist, behind you. Try to use that left hand to kind of pull down on that lower hip, the buttock. It'll free up your back. Take your right palm. You're reversing your warrior. Reversing a time in your life. You just followed the crowd. You didn't want to make a scene. Maybe you didn't want to be seen. Most of my life, I wanted to just evaporate into the floor. Go figure, huh? Cartwheel down.
High plank. Low. Upward dog. Downward dog. Step your left foot forward. Turn your back foot down.
Reach up. Open wide. Warrior two. Keep opening that left knee to the baby toe side. Knee over the ankle. Take the arms out straight. For a lot of us, we're at the computer all day, or you're driving, or you're carrying laundry or groceries, and your shoulders are up like earrings. What you want to do is you want to actually lower your shoulders down by dropping your arms down below shoulder level. Pull the arms apart. Length through your fingers. And you want your middle finger to be where your focus is and your breath. Take your right arm, wrap it around your back. Flip your left palm up. And as you breathe in, reverse your warrior. Sometimes we need to go backwards just to go forward in our life. Far forward, actually. Cartwheel right down.
Step back, high push up, breathe in, low exhale, upward facing, inhale, downward facing, out breath.
When the air is cleared out through longer exhales, we will settle our own nervous system. So I like to say, ideally, we become our own clearing. And all that is exhaling is going to help us release what's kind of coagulated and what's just been clogged up. Sometimes we'll turn the pipe, the faucet on, and the water needs to be rusty before it can run clear. Yoga's like that.
Walk, feet forward. Halfway up, breathe in. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, reach up, bring your palms together, and shoot right up tall. Go ahead, inhale, reach up. Exhale, you're gonna take your right arm under and your right leg over. You're gonna squeeze your thighs like they're concrete. Helps if you draw the tailbone in. You're gonna pull your arms up. Release. Left arm, left leg. If your shoulders are really tight, you've got your left leg wrapped around. Some people need to bring their left foot to the outside of their right foot on the floor. Less can be so much more for somebody, you know, especially when you're first learning. Left arm under, or the forearms can come together. Elbows and shoulders line up. Squeeze your thighs. Draw your tailbone in. Belly tight. Release. Reach up. Hands to your good height. There's a lot of people that will tell me they need help with their balance. But what we don't often talk about is how much this practice will help us to level out emotionally and mentally our balance. All this practice is seeking balance. Go ahead, grab your knee, and with your left hand on your left hip, I want you to hug your right leg towards your body. The physical balance, it's a byproduct. Keep hugging the leg like you're squeezing it towards you, and then go ahead and open that right leg out. If we're simply more balanced, we have an opportunity to be less reactive. Come back. Bring your hands to your heart. Grab your right ankle. If you can, bring it into the top of your left thigh. This is simply a practice. We practice being centered. We practice finding balance. Trust me, as soon as you think you've found it and you've mastered it, the yoga gods, they'll test you. They'll have the world coming at you and say, well, how do you react with all this newfangled equanimity? Let's see it. Interlace your fingers. Press your palms up. If you want, look up. Release. Go ahead, take your left knee, hug it in. Right hand on the hip. Zip up your core and squeeze this standing leg. It's been holding you up your whole life. It's not going to quit on you now. Squeeze your leg. Go to a little bit of an edge. Find out what you're really made of, you know. Open it out to the side. I like to squeeze that leg toward the side of my body. It feels like I have more integrity with it. Come back. Grab the ankle if you can. Bring it right into the center of your thigh. Bring your palms together. And just do the pose. In fact, move from doing to being. What kind of tree are you? How do you withhold? How do you withstand the storms of your own life, the challenges of your own life? When push comes to shove, can you be pushed around? Do you back down? And can you take back some of that power that you've been giving away, but in a loving way? Reach up. Come down. Come to the front of your mat. Bend your knees. Arms reach. Fold.
Halfway. High push up. Lower. Upward dog. Downward facing dog. Take your right foot forward and your back foot down.
Rise up. With the inhale, I want the inhale to take the arms up. I want the exhale to open you into warrior two. The right knee squeezes open. The outer edge of the back foot presses toward the outer edge of the mat, or back edge of your mat. And then reverse your warrior again. Right leg straighten it. Reach out. And take your right hand down to your shin. Maybe some of you grab your ankle. It's important to keep the lungs lifted. If you keep the lungs lifted, you can breathe easier. Breathe in. Press your right hip back towards your back foot. Breathe out. Come on up. All 10 toes will face forward. You're going to bring your hands together at your heart. You're going to then turn your heels in and your knees and toes out. And you're going to exhale and you're going to drop down. Try to lengthen your tailbone toward the ground instead of sticking your butt out. So horse stance. You're going to press those knees and thighs open. Press them back. Sit a little bit lower. Ground down through the feet and anchor in through the breath. No matter what comes up, I'm here with you, you're here with you. I'm in the fire with you, as you can see. I don't like it either. If someone said horse stance, I'd say, I don't wanna. But I'd rather do the poses that do the work to release tension and stay numb. Staying numb is simply a survival technique for a lot of us. It certainly was for me. The sucky part was is that I didn't really get to feel my kids' laughter or my own. And yoga called on me to do big work, to help myself and heal myself and free myself. That's what I want for you. Free you of excess tension, numbness. Shift you out of your anxiety, depression, fatigue. Just a kind of a lackluster, blah feeling. I want to shake you out of that nicely. Reach up. Hands to the ground.
High push up. Exhale, lower.
Upward dog.
Down facing. Step your left foot forward, back foot down.
Warrior one, warrior two. Reverse. Triangle. Left leg straightens. Left hip will press toward the back heel. Left arm, lengthen it so you get length through the ribs, through the spine. Then open it up. Come on up. Okay, I'm going to have you turn so all 10 toes face the wall in front of you, but I'm actually going to stand close again so that you hear me. So I'm going to take the pose that you're doing on that side, okay? You're gonna ground down through the outer edges of the feet, and you're gonna firm up these legs. You want to know in your life you need to be able to stand on your own feet, proud and confident. And I hope these classes will help get you there or support that. Hands behind your back, please. Interlace your fingers, palms pressed together if possible, and squeeze your shoulder blades together. Squeeze your knuckles toward the ground. Lift your chest up and really spread your shoulders and collarbones open wide. Squeeze your shoulder blades, squeeze them. Fold forward.
Let your head drop. And let every exhale soften your middle back. Come on up.
On the inhale, you'll come up. You're going to turn the left toes. And you're going to come back down.
You're going to come into high push-up and low. And up facing and downward facing. You're going to bring your knees down. You're going to fold the mat over 5 or 6 times. All I really want for you is that you fold your mat enough so that you have a nice cushion. Love for your knees, okay? This practice will help you love yourself better and definitely bigger. Come onto the balls of your feet if it's too much on your low back. Hands fully support your hips, low back. You lengthen your tailbone down. You press those hips forward, heart lifting, head coming back. You want more of a lift up and then the back bend. Try to hug your shoulder blades to your mid-spine. And then come on up. I'd like you to just sit your butt back on your heels. Or your butt between your heels. Hands to your thighs. Pause. Another way to soothe the nervous system is just take the thumbs into the middle of your palms and just very lightly, not tight-fisted, like a baby, just very gentle, rest them on your thighs. Notice your breathing. Let's do it one more time.
If you can, you can grab the heels of the feet. Again, you're on the balls of your feet. Lengthen the tailbone, zip up the belly. Press those hips forward. Hug those shoulder blades together behind you. Head dropping. Head will melt. If it bothers your neck at all, chin to your chest. You can catch your heels. And keep remembering, hips forward. Heart lifting, head back. Come on up.
Sit between your heels or on your heels. Thumbs, lightly, cup around, fingers cup around the thumbs. Rest them on your thighs. Close your eyes. Where are you right now? So much of our day, so much of our life can be spent so checked out. We'll get like a quick surge of energy if the food's good enough or sweet enough or the shirt in the mall is cute enough. But we want to buy things that are vital. Not just vital, like meaningful, like, yeah, it's functional, so I need it. We want to buy things that feel, we feel something in our heart when we see them in our home. Otherwise, it's just stuff. And clutter just takes up a lot of energy. Whether it's clutter in the mind, or clutter in an attic, clutter in your junk drawer, clutter in your bedroom. Go ahead, come right out onto your seat. And bring your feet flat.
You're going to take your right arm around your shins. You're going to sit up nice and tall. Fingertips go behind you on the ground. I want you to push your right buttock forward. Breathe in. Exhale out to twist. Inhale. Twist. The place you can't go any further, stay there and soften out through the exhale. And then another inhale. And then soften out through the twist. Feels good, right? Take the other side. Left arm across the shins. Fingertips here. Rock that left hip forward. Sit up tall. Twist. Right where you're stuck, exhale there. Don't stop the pose. And you use your exhales to gently allow for a deeper twist. Not forcing, not cramming it, not making it happen. That's brute. Don't be a brute. Don't be a bully to yourself. Breathe in. Twist one more time. Come back. Bring the soles of the feet together. And with the soles of the feet together, sit up tall. Use the exhale to fold. If you need to slide your feet out a little further or bring them in a little closer, what have you. In your body will tell you by this what you feel. Guess what? That's the information to pay attention to. Your head can't really help you here. Being in your head about this pose and wondering what you need, no, go to your body. Your body has the answer. On the mat, in this pose, in your life. Pull the chest forward, drop down. Inhale, you're gonna lift your chest up and you're gonna lengthen out that spine away from your low back. You're gonna fold. Sit up nice and tall. I'd like you today to just sit cross-legged. Thumbs, fingers. Eyes closed. Not so that your eyes are not closed so that you check out. Your eyes are closed so that you'll kind of ignite flame of your inner sight, the third eye mind, the part of you that knows better. The part of you that knows deeper. The part of you that holds an answer. The part of you that aches to be heard. Acknowledged and cared for. And the part of you, just like the part of me, that has resistance to the practice, resistance to the day, resistance to someone in relationship, someone you might know, part of you that pulls back, part of you that's scared, part of you that's angry. Part of you that's making yourself sick with all your secrets. Or holding grief in because you're afraid to open the gate on it. All of that will come forth with ease. If you hold a loving space for the part of yourself that you think you can't love. You can't accept that you judge, and others can mirror that. Invite in a part of yourself that you absolutely love and have forgotten. invite in a part of yourself to move towards more self-forgiveness for the part of you that you wish you could deny, reject, scorn, alienate. When you bring all the parts of you together, that's unconditional love. And that'll move you into more awakening within yourself, that you already are whole. That there is nothing wrong with you. There's nothing broken. There's nothing to fix. For all the self-help books out there, you're good. There's a part of you inherently good. It was a magic you were infused with when you came into being the day you were born. It's the divine part of you. The shadow says, block that out. Turn that down. I hope this practice, my work, my presence in your life helps you to turn it up. Namaste.